automation can be used in the arrangement view to record changes of different parameters. Let's take a look in detail how you can use automation in the arrangement view. Automation in the arrangement view can be recorded in one of two ways. It can be recorded manually within the arrangement view while recording new material, or it can be recorded while recording session view clips into the arrangement view and where the session view clips already contain clip automation. If you make any manual changes to parameters during a session view to arrangement view recording, these will be recorded into the arrangement also. The automation mode button allows you to toggle between the track content and track automation. As a shortcut, you can also press A on your keyboard to toggle the automation mode on and off. Let's take a look at recording automation directly into the arrangement view. I'd like to record an automation of the filter device on track 1. To record the automation, first I need to make sure that the automation arm is enabled. I'll set the insert marker shortly before where I'd like to record the automation. Then I'll hit the arrangement record button. I'll adjust the parameter of the filter. And when I finish recording the automation, I'll press the record automation button again to stop recording. If you make any adjustments to a parameter after the automation has been recorded, then the automation will be overridden and will turn grey. To re-enable the automation, simply click the Re-enable Automation button. Another way to add automation into the arrangement view, as opposed to recording the automation, is to use breakpoints. I can use the device chooser to select the device I'd like to add the automation to. Directly underneath, I can use the chooser to select which parameter I'd like to automate. A device parameter that contains no automation will be represented by a dotted red line. I can simply double-click on the dotted red line to create a breakpoint. In this case, I'll create several breakpoints. With each of my breakpoints, I'll drag them up or down to create an automation. Breakpoints will always snap to the grid that you're currently using in the arrangement view. If you wish to temporarily disable the snap to grid function, hold down Command on a Mac or Control on Windows while dragging a breakpoint. You can also add automation by enabling the draw mode switch. The draw mode switch will also allow you to add automation that is relative to the current grid that you're using in the arrangement view. If you'd like to temporarily disable the grid while using the draw mode tool, then hold down Command on a Mac or Control on Windows while using the draw tool. If you'd like to move a breakpoint horizontally, but so that it remains at its current parameter value, hold down Shift while moving the breakpoint horizontally. If you'd like to increase or decrease the parameter value of a breakpoint with a fine resolution, hold down Shift while moving the breakpoint vertically. You can add a curve to automation in between two breakpoints. To do this, simply move the mouse cursor to the automation line, hold down Alt on the computer keyboard, and then drag the line to create a curve. You can lock envelopes using the Lock Envelope button in the arrangement view. If this is activated, all automation envelopes will not be affected by you editing a clip and moving it. If it's unlocked, all envelopes will follow the clip's movement. If I'd like to duplicate the automation envelope that I've created in the arrangement view, I'll click the insert marker into the arrangement and select the region of automation that I'd like to duplicate. And then right-click and select Duplicate. Alternatively, as a shortcut, I can use Command-D on a Mac or Control-D on Windows. You can also add automation lanes in the arrangement view. This can help you to have a full overview of automation that has been recorded in a particular track. And it can also allow you to add automation lanes. To add an automation lane, go to the device chooser in the track and select the device. Then directly underneath, select the parameter that you'd like to automate. Click on the Add Automation button. Thank you.